pleasant surprise.
Our old dear friend, Susan.
I believe I already know Dr. Putnam.
Hello, Susan.
Nice to see you again, Doctor.
Well, I see you've decided to ignore my advice and aren't staying close to home.
Oh, across the river isn't all that far. A mere telescope away. Right, Alan?
On a clear day, I suppose it is.
You're feeling better, then?
Like $1 million. Maybe even two.
I had no idea you were friends of the Quartermains.
They didn't tell you? Oh, sure. Our association goes way back. Hard to believe, I know. I'm not exactly of the same stock and good name that they are, but I'm pretty much an equal. Right, Monica?
Like a sister.
Grant, would you like a tour of the house? Stella can take you around whilst I check on things in the kitchen. You'll forgive us, won't you, Susan?
Of course, Lila.
Come along, dear, this way.
Excuse me, please.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Alan.
Relax. I wasn't about to tell him anything.
You had better not.
This is between you and me. I'll respect your need for discretion.
Okay, cut the act and just tell us what the hell you want.
I had a visitor earlier today, a Mr. Wharton, I believe. That is his name, isn't it, Edward?
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Aha. That's funny, because he told me that he works for you. He said something would happen to me if I didn't lay off. How can you all be so stupid? Don't you know that threats are only going to make things worse for you?
Just tell us what you want.
I want you to call off Wharton. I don't ever want to see him near me or my house again.
And if I don't?
I go to the police.
You'd be willing to expose yourself as a blackmailer.
Only one way to find that out, Monica. Try me.
You should call first. I got a busy schedule tonight.
What for? You just come barging into my office?
This is my home.
This is your home, huh? Nice place, Anthony. Real nice.
Get to the point, Baldwin.
I got a court order. We're gonna have to hold off from evicting the tenants from the clinic.
So what's that supposed to mean?
Did you just hear what I said?
Yeah, we can't level the clinic for how long?
30 days. It's a restraining order.
So get it reversed. Talk to your friends at City Hall.
All right, look, I'm working on it. I just want to let you know that we're at a temporary standstill, okay? So we'll just have to hold back on some of the paperwork.
Another delay. Man, what is it with you? You're never going to get this thing moving.
I'm moving on it, all right? It's just going to take some time, but in the meantime, we'll work around it until the restraining order's all cleared up.
Yeah, until you clear it up. It's your mess. You clean it up. I'm moving ahead in other areas.
Oh, yeah? What are you moving into?
Well, that's none of your business, boy.
Great. You're a great business partner, Anthony. Real good.
I learned it all from you. Get the door on your way out.
Anthony, I think one of your Cub Scouts is checking in.
Send him in.
Who's that?
That is my biggest problem right now.
Got himself a bad attitude.
Hey, did I ask for your opinion? No. Now, what do you want?
A message from Auggie. He said he's got some new girls right off the train. He figures with the new mall coming in, you'll need some more girls.
Well, for once, Augie's got a point.
He says he'll send you a couple if you want it.
Yeah. Why don't you tell him to wrap up a couple of his finest and send them on over? I think I'm going to have myself a little party tonight.
There's no reason for all these unnecessary threats. We want this to work out just as much as you do.
You have enough information on us to ensure our cooperation.
Your use of Wharton makes me question your cooperation.
Well, what do you want us to do? Name it.
Fire him.
He does lots of work for the Quartermains. I can't...
Fire him. Or I go to the police and yell harassment.
All right, I'll take care of it.
Now.
Tomorrow morning.
Now. Unless you want me to go to the newspaper office for my second visit.
Get on with it, Edward. I haven't got all day.
Hello, Wharton. Edward Quartermain.
Yes, Mr. Quartermain.
You've overstepped your authority. You're fired.
What are you talking about?
Another day or two, I'll have a lock on Tolliver. We're extremely close.
Yeah, that's all well and good, but I've made up my mind.
She told you about my visit?
No arguments. Now, you've heard my decision.
She's there, isn't she?
Yes, exactly. I can't permit these kind of tactics. You're to leave Mrs. Baldwin alone and get off the case.
I'll keep looking for Tolliver.
You do that. Good day, sir. I hope you're satisfied.
I will be.
When?
So we can plan the celebration.
At our next meeting, which will be next week. Let's see, 1 week from Friday, 10 p.m.
And if you value your gold-plated hides, you'll be on time.
That's when you plan to name the price.
Maybe. Good day, Quartermates.
Do either of you two brilliant men have any ideas as what we're going to do?
Well, I'm going upstairs and take a nap. Perhaps in a subconscious state, I can come up with a solution to this problem.
I'm going to finish my reports.
Well, I might as well take a bath.
Polly, you're doing this for economics. Well, there's absolutely no reason to have to marry Robert Scorpio. We'll just band together and pool our money.
Right.
Let's get an apartment.
Yeah.
But with my not having a job, that's not going to be very fast.
We'll find you a job.
No, without a green card.
Under the table, we'll get you one. You can help out Rose Kelly or Delphina or the Webbers.
That's right. Nothing too strenuous.
Just something to tide you over till the baby comes.
Oh, you're both so kind. You know, you don't have to be. This could all end up being a terrible burden to you both.
I don't want to hear you talk like that.
That's right. We're Spencers. We stick together. Don't you worry about a thing. Everything's going to be just fine.
You know, even though he's gone, I still feel like Luke is here and helping us.
Well, he is. Right there, little Luke.
Hereafter to be known as Wonder Baby. Oh.
Hello.
Hi, Bobbie, it's Rose. Listen, by any chance, is Holly there? I tried Ruby's apartment. There wasn't an answer.
Hold on a minute. As a matter of fact, they're both sitting right here.
Holly, it's Rose. Sounds important.
Rose?
Hi, Holly. Listen, I'm sorry to bother you, but there's this guy here named Farrell from the Immigration Department, and he's been hanging around since noon waiting to see you. What should I do? Do you want me to get rid of him or what?
No, it's not necessarily bad news. It could be something to do with my green card.
Okay, I'll keep him busy till you can get here.
Thanks.
We can all take turns babysitting.
What is it? Somebody from immigration. They want to see me.
Well, what happened? That was fast. You'll look very good, Scotty.
I don't feel very good either.
Anything to do with the mall?
So what else is new?
That's why your father was here, wasn't it?
Yeah, another delay. Every time things start to go, okay, something's gotta goof up. Come on, let's have a drink. Hey, where are the glasses at?
Right in the second drawer.
Would you get them for me?
What do you think you're doing?
I'm making myself comfortable.
I thought you wanted a drink, Scotty.
I changed my mind, Heather.
Not now.
What's the matter, Heather? You're always very responsive to that kind of a situation.
I'm not in the mood, Scotty. It's fine when I'm in the mood, but I'm not in the mood right now, okay?
Okay. I'll give you a couple of minutes. Let me know when you are.
Why don't you just trash the smug act? I am not some machine you turn off and on when you want to, Scotty. I'm a woman. I have a heart, I have a mind, and I'm not some slut.
I never said that you were a slut.
You don't give a damn about me.
I do. Okay, then why are you working here if I don't give a damn?
You want some concubine. Someone who's convenient to have around when you feel like it. Why can't you treat me like a woman? A person? Why can't we share things on some kind of genuine level?
I never thought you wanted to be treated that way. Hey, wait a sec. Hey, what's going on here?
You tell me.
Heather, listen. I never open up to you because I always think you want something or you're always after something, okay? I thought we had this kind of arrangement between each, you know, where I do you a favor, you do me a favor. It's kind of a trade-off. I thought that's what it was with us.
Why can't we have something more?
Is that what you want?
You do.
You mean you want a relationship?
It's not a disease, Scotty.
A relationship.
If it's an honest one.
I never knew.
Maybe I didn't either.
Hey, Heather.
Scotty.
It's okay if I... Can I kiss you?
I think that'd be all right. Did you lock the door?
No.
Why not?
Because I gotta get to the courthouse. I have an appointment at the mall.
Well, cancel it, Scotty.
I can't do that, Heather.
You're gonna pass me up to go pick up some permit? I can't believe it. You really know how to make a woman feel wanted.
Listen, I'm gonna make it up to you, okay?
When?
As soon as the mall's finished.
Be careful, Scotty. That almost sounds like a commitment.
Maybe it is.
Made myself at home.
So I see.
You look startled.
Well, I really wasn't expecting you.
Apparently not. Where have you been, Susan?
Well, I've been right here, of course. Where else would I be?
You weren't 20 minutes ago. I called and then I stopped by. No sign of Susan. I thought to myself, I wonder where she is. Where could she have gone without telling me?
All right, I went to the Quartermaine's.
Why? I thought everything was settled. At least that's what you said.
I know, and it is settled. I just wanted to be sure there was no mistake in the agreement.
They summoned you?
No, I went on my own.
Didn't we agree that there'd be no more contact?
Okay, we did, but I got a little worried. I wanted to be sure that they would have the money for us.
Was that your only reason?
Well, that, and I wanted to try to get them to stop trying to find you. I mean, we both know how important it is for you to stay undercover. What's wrong?
Nothing. That was very thoughtful of you, Susan. We'll be talking again soon.
Dad. What are you doing puttering around in here in the dark?
I was just balancing my checkbook.
In the dark?
Well, I was going to turn the lights on.
Well, the way you balance your books, you're better off not seeing the results. I thought you were going to look over some medical reports.
I thought you were going to take a nap.
Well, I couldn't sleep. What about the reports?
Oh, wait.
Well, what are you two doing here?
Well, the genius here is balancing his checkbook, and I came down for a brandy. What's your excuse?
Came down to get my magazine.
I thought you were going to take a shower.
Bath.
Well, what does that have to do with magazines?
I read in the bathtub.
Oh, I didn't know.
Well, it's not exactly cocktail party conversation.
Well, what do you plan to read tonight when you soak? A Doctor's Life, My Adventures in Medicine. How about Nurse Chatterley's Lover?
How about just an old medical journal?
Torrid stuff.
Ah, yes, here it is.
Well, I guess I better get my brandy.
Yes, I guess I better draw my bath.
Are you coming out?
Yes, of course.
Looking for me.
Holly Sutton?
Right.
I'm Roger Farrell with the immigration office. I wonder if I might have a word with you.
Sure.
Sit down, please.
I'll assume this has something to do with my green card situation.
In a way, yes.
I'd appreciate it if you'd be straightforward with me, Mr. Farrell.
I intend to be. As you know, you've been denied green card status. However, when Commissioner Scorpio reported this to our office, the computer uncovered the fact of your involvement in the oil swindle.
I was acquitted, Mr. Farrell.
I know that. But what you may not know is that your visa has expired.
Oh, I'll have it taken care of right away.
No, you don't understand, Miss Sutton. I'm here because we're not granting you a visa.
You can't do that.
We can if we determine that you're an undesirable alien.
But you have no right. I haven't done anything.
Miss Sutton, our department has determined that your role in the oil swindle is sufficient reason for denial.
Mr. Farrell, I don't have anywhere else to go.
Well, I'm sorry. That's not our business. You've got 24 hours to leave the United States.
Or?
Or you'll be arrested and deported.